Morning, everyone. How are you doing today? So I got a subscriber question, actually the first one in a while. Just in case you're new to the channel and you don't know what a subscriber question is, all you have to do is go to any of the videos, simply leave a comment, that's your question. And you know, with that, again, I'm a one-man show. I see what they are and then I go and I do my best to answer them for you. So today's question is about interest rates, and more specifically, hey, interest rates have gone down. You know, when should I look to refinance? So a couple of thoughts. First and foremost, interest rate, you know, the higher the interest rate or lower interest rate, whatever it is, the interest rate in and of itself, it does certainly have an impact on your cash flow. So obviously a lower interest rate, all else being equal, is a good idea. However, you know, there are, you know, I have some guidelines, and again, the question was for me. So I have some guidelines about when I go back to refi and all of that. So first thing to know is in most cases, at least every case I've gone back and done a refinance, what you need to realize is a cash out refi or a refi of a mortgage is often a tick higher than your purchase money mortgage, right? When you purchase an investment property or your owner occupant house, that will likely be the cheapest money you can get. So if you are looking to refinance said property, you know, years later, you're not going to get the bottom of the barrel, at least in most cases, as far as interest rate goes, because you're not purchasing, right? You're refinancing. So it's just the way it's worked, at least in my experience. I don't know if it's true all the time, but my history says it is true all the time. A purchase money interest rate is going to be the lowest. So if the purchase money interest rate is 3.8, you know, a refi is probably going to be north of 4. So I share that with you because a lot of times we as investors hear an interest rate number. Hey, you know, I just read this morning rates are down to 3.82. First off, that's for owner-occupant, not investor, right? We have to know these things. And also, it's not for an investment, or it is for an investment purchase, not an investment refi. So when you hear these low rates, check yourself and go back and find out what your rate would be, because it's not, in most cases, going to be the rates that we hear quoted on TV or read in the paper or online. So just realize that. So the gap is probably not as wide as you thought it was going to be. The second thing to think about is refinancing has costs. You know, it's thousands of dollars. You know, depending on the property of itself, could be, you know, several thousand dollars. So, you know, would I do a cash out or would I do a refi, even if I didn't take cash out, to save $37 a month when I had to pay $3,000? Probably not, right? It's, you know, it's 100 months to get my money back, you know? So, I have to ask myself some questions when I look at a refinance. First, how long do I plan to keep the property, right? Is this something I could see holding until I'm dead? Is this something I want to hold to the peak of the market and maybe 1031 exchange? Is this a property that's been giving me problems and I should probably sell and clean up my portfolio? You know, what are all the reasons, right? If I'm looking to hold it till I'm dead, it goes to the list that, you know, maybe I'll refi. But if it's something I'm going to sell in the next 5 years or exchange, or if I want to get rid of it because it's a dud, then there's probably no chance that I will look at refi. The biggest reason I refi is because I want to take cash out. So in that case, the rate means, I mean, it means something. But for me, it's, okay, can I maintain cash flow positive because I don't want to create alligators? You heard about the first alligator I created in my book, which was really painful and really stupid. So for me, it's always about, can I take cash out, right? I think a typical refi just for interest rate where you save under $100 and you have to pay $3,000 to $5,000 typically doesn't make it worth it. If for whatever reason, maybe you were taking it down 2 percentage points and you're saving $400 a month or $350 and you have to spend $3,000, right? You get your money back in a year, maybe 18 months, and you plan to keep it forever, probably worth it. But if you're going to be saving, you know, under $100 and it's going to be, you know, I don't know, 40 months to get back, it's probably not worth it, in my opinion, unless you want to take cash out, right? If you can take cash out and then keep the, keep your payment roughly even, you know, now we're talking, right? You spend three to get 20 and the payment stays the same. Pretty interesting, because you can use that net 17, right? Spend three, get 20, net 17, to be half a down payment or maybe a full down payment or something else. So for me, a refi is always, again, I first qualify it. Am I going to keep this forever? Or is this an exchange in 5 years, or I need to sell and clean up? If it's either of the latter two, the refi is off the table. Because a refi takes work, lots of paperwork, all of that. So I want to make sure I'm holding forever. For me, I really consider refis when I can use it to extract equity and buy something else. Those are the things. But lastly, if you're looking for a rule of thumb, I would like to get my money back on a refi in under 2 years. That would be interesting to me. I think if I can get my money back in under 2 years, again, being fixed rate, 30-year money, especially in today's environment, those are interesting ideas. So again, this was a subscriber question. If you're watching this, you are a subscriber. So leave a question if you have one. Again, I do my best to answer them typically within 2 to 3 days. So let me know what you have. And if you have questions, leave them below. Thanks for watching and enjoy your day.